have my stuff, please?
I found them. There you are, Mr. Starks.
Huh? Mr. Starks?
John Starks of the New York Knicks. I think I know a professional athlete in the first class check-in area when I see one.
What?
Shawn, she thinks I'm John Starks, man.
I'm sorry, Mr. Starks, but you and your manager don't have to wait here with the common passengers. You're in first class and you can board right now.
Oh, I'm sorry. There must be some kind of mistake. See, we don't even have any tickets.
Well, of course you don't, because I do. Right here. Two first class tickets.
Thank you. Thank you very much. God bless you, babe. Say a prayer. Okay. We go in first class? Are you nuts? No, I am John Starks. And me and you, my friend, are traveling first class. See, says right here, Mr. Jonathan Starks, that's me, and here's your ticket. Boy. Mom, you are crazy. We are not getting on that plane.
Why not?
Because first of all, it's illegal. Second of all, Lisa's at home waiting on me.
I can't believe I'm hearing this.
You used to be mad fun back in the day. And now, ever since Lisa came along and she gave you some sunshine, you've been whipped. What did you say to me? You heard me, you're whipped. Whoosh. You're whipped like Denzel Washington in Glory. Like Morgan Freeman in Unforgiven. And LeVar Burton and everything he ever does. Whipped, huh? You think I'm whipped? You must be crazy. I ain't whipped. I tell you right now. Whipped is the last thing I am. I'll show you whipped. Kunta Kinte of love. Excuse me. But my client over here, Mr. John Starks of the New York Knickerbockers. Is highly upset right now that there was no one here earlier to meet him with his bags. Now, if this is the level of service...
You're right. I'm so sorry, sir. On behalf of myself and our airline, let me be the first to extend to you a complimentary bag of our very own airline peanuts.
I'm sorry, but this is unacceptable. That's better. You may go.
She still got two bags!
Nah, you the man, see? I'm just a squirrel in your world trying to get a what?
A peanut.
Here we go, Mr. Starks. More delicious peanuts.
Thank you.
Our in-flight magazine.
Ooh.
And some little wings to pin on our shirt.
You shouldn't have.
Now, is there anything else I can get for you boys?
I'll have some more peanuts and a glass of champagne. No ice.
Yes, sir. And you, Mr. Starks?
I'll have something to drink as well. I'll have, 40 ounce. No bag.
Yes, Mr. Starks. And, oh, I'm sorry, I didn't get your name.
Mr. Williams. He takes care of me when I'm on the road.
Oh, I see. Like a personal valet or a cabana boy. Perhaps like the one I met in Mallorca last winter who won't return my phone calls.
Oh, no. I'm just Mr. Stark's manager.
Of course you are.
Nice guy. Oh, Shawn, are we living large or what? I can't believe you talked me into this. Come on, man, relax. Take it easy. Enjoy first class. We don't even know where we're going.
Excuse me, fellas. If you don't mind my asking, are you an entertainer or an athlete? Or are you one of those rappers that my kids just seem to love?
And if you don't mind me asking, why do you think all black people gotta be athletes and entertainers?
Yeah. Oh, no, I don't think that about all black people. Of course not. Just the ones found in first class.
Yeah? And I bet you're just some rich white guy who owns a lot of land, has a beautiful wife, and drives a luxury automobile.
Exactly.
I guess I told that guy, huh? Hello, my Caucasian friend. Good to see you. This is the life. Man, I can't believe we're sitting up here in first class pretending to be John Starks.
And boy.
Man, I just hope nobody ever finds out about this.
This is your co-pilot. We should be landing in Cleveland in just under an hour.
Help me, somebody! Help me, please! Help me! I ain't the motel chicks! Get off of me!